Hello friends, a very warm welcome to all the viewers of Wisdom Jobs. In this video, we are going to present a very new topic and a new concept which is in the form of every question containing every one in one video. So these videos and these questions are very useful in many competitive examinations like take IIT JEE or RRB or NTPC or CHSL examinations. So please do subscribe to our channel wisdomjobs.com because these videos are very much useful for you in your success. So with this note, let me start with the question. The number of electrons in the d subshell are a6 b2 c10 and d14. Okay, now what is the value of p for l subshell? So I mean for d subshell. So for d subshell, l will take a value of 2. Okay, now for d subshell, l will take a value of 2. So the number of electrons that can be accommodated in any subshell with a azimuthal quantum number of l is 2l into l plus 1, or in other words also I can say that we have got 5 orbitals in d subshell. Okay, so what are they? They are d xy, d yz, d zx and d x square minus y square and d z square. So these are the different orbitals in the d subshell. So each orbital can contain 2 electrons by Pauli's exclusion principle. So if each electron is containing, sorry, each orbital is containing 2 electrons, how many electrons are possible here? 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, which will give you 10. I mean, yeah, 10 electrons. So in a d subshell, we can have how many electrons? We can have 10 electrons. So the same can be interpreted in another way. So we have got one formula, 2 into 2l plus 1. This is one more formula by which I can determine the number of electrons in a particular subshell. So for d subshell, what is the value of l? L is 2. So let us substitute that value of l equal to 2 in this formula. So 2 into 2 plus 1, so that will be how much? 2 into 2 is how much? 4 plus 1, which give you 5. So it will give you 10. So you can conclude that we have got 5 10 electrons in this method, or also by formula method. So this is the formula. So if you remember this formula for the maximum number of electrons in a particular subshell, then you can easily remember how many electrons are present in each subshell. Okay. Now if you take the option A is not a perfect option because we got an answer of 10. Similarly, if you take option B, it is also wrong, and obviously option D also is a wrong option for our formula. So using that formula, since I got 10, option C is the correct option for us. I hope you have enjoyed these videos, as these videos are useful for you in your preparation for different competitive examinations like RRB, NTPC, CGL and CHSL. So please do subscribe to our channel wisdomjobs.com and also share these videos to your friends so that they also will be more benefited about these concepts, and it will be a sort of encouragement for us to do more and more number of videos. So if you have got any queries or doubts regarding these videos, please do express your doubts or queries in the form of comments provided below the video, so that we can revert back to you and answer your queries at the earliest. Thank you for watching these videos. Have a nice time.